So welcome everybody. Today in this video we are going to discuss about an array. So what is an array? So array is a collection of items stored in a contiguous memory. Okay. So what is a contiguous memory? The contiguous memory here, I mean that the memory that is separated by certain boundaries. Okay. So let me show you something here. So let me consider this as a memory block in a computer. Okay. So it has 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 spaces, let me consider. Okay, so when you define an array, it will take the size of an array also. Okay, the length of an array. Okay, so when you define the length of an array, the computer will first allocate some free memory spaces. Okay, if you define the 5 as a length of an array, then the computer will allocate the 5 free spaces. Okay, 5 free blocks like this. Okay, so and if the first element of an array is 10, then that will be stored in this first memory block. Okay, if second element is 20, then it will store here. The third element is 7, then it will be stored here, and the fourth element is stored here, fifth element is stored here, and so on. Okay, so and the another one thing you have to know about an array is the index. Okay, so each array is defined by an index. Okay, so index of an array always start with 0. Okay, so this first element is in the index of 0. Okay, second element will be in the index of 1, the third element will be in the index of 2, the fourth element will be in the index of 3, and fifth element will be index of the 4, and so on. Now let me show you how we can define such array and how we can take the input to an array and print an output of an array. Okay, the elements contained in the array. So let me first define some standard library match int. To define an array, first of all we have to decide so what kind of data type we are going to store in an array. Okay, so it can be character type, floating type, integer type, or any other. Okay, so if you are going to define an integer array, then you have to use the keyword in and the variable name, or you can say here is an array name and give a big bracket, and inside this big bracket you have to define the length of an array. Okay, how many elements does an array can have? So the array can contain the 5 numbers only. It cannot contain more than 5 numbers. Okay, to take an input for an array, we have to use a for loop here, because we are going to take the input for 5 times. Okay, so we are repeatedly taking an input, so we have to use a for loop here. Okay, so for and I equals to 0, I less than 5, I plus plus. Okay, so scanf percent is the ampersand of a. Okay, what will happen here is for every index we will take an input. Okay, it will take a number and store it in the every index starting from 0 to, it will go from less than 5, that is it will go for 4. Okay, so what will happen here is in a 0th index, it will here will be the first input. Let's say first input is 5, so the 5 will be stored in this 0th index. Okay, and if the second input is 10, then the second input will be stored in this first one in index 1. Okay, so it will go to the index 4. Okay, so I have taken an input. Okay, so now let me say I have to print the all the numbers that is contained in an array. Okay, so first let me print a message, slash n, the numbers in an array are. Okay, for printing the number in an array also we have to use the for loop. Okay, why? Because in the array there is more than one numbers. Okay, so we have to repeatedly print the each and every numbers. Okay, so we have to use for loop here. For in I equals to 0, I less than 5, I plus plus. Okay, so print f percentage b and a. Okay, so it will print a number for every index in an array. Okay, so let me compile this. Okay, so there is no any error. So let me run this. You can press F11 to run. So okay, let me give the input to 5 numbers. Okay, so you will give 1, 10, 4, 5, 7. Okay, the 5 number here is completed. Okay, so the numbers in an array are 1, 10, 4. Okay, let me make it more readable. So you can, what you can do is print every number in the new line. Okay, so let me run this. Okay, so let me give input 10, 20, 30, 40, and 50. Okay, so numbers in an array are 10, 20, 30, 40, and 50. Okay, so in this way, we can take the input from an array and print it to the user. Okay, so okay, now let me show how can you can get the particular value from an array by giving an index. Okay, so what you can do is print f. Okay, let me remove this. Print f slash that. Okay. First number in an array is percent d. Okay, so the percent d is represent integer. So a. So the first index here is what? 0. So you should not write here 1. Okay, the 1 here represents the second number. So to get the first number, you have to write 0. Okay, so let me run this. So let me give the input 10, 40, 50, 90, 3. Okay. So the first number in an array is 10. So the number in the first what we have given input is 10, so we get back the 10. Okay, in this way we can get the number according to the index in an array. Okay, so if you understand this, or like a habit, we do some operation. Okay, so what we are going to do here is we are going to find the sum of the numbers that are stored in the array. Okay, if the numbers that are stored in the array is 10, 20, 30, 40, and 50, then we are going to sum all these numbers. Okay, 10 plus 20 plus 30 plus 40 plus 50, and we are going to take a sum back. Okay, so for this, let me define one variable here, sum equals to 0. Okay, so initialize to 0. So what we are going to do here is we will take the input also, and we are going to continuously add to the sum variable also. Okay, so the sum will be sum plus the number that is coming as an input from the user. Okay, if the user, let's say entered a 10, okay, then the sum here will be what? Sum will be equals to sum plus, okay, sum plus the sum here initializes as 0, so sum is 0 plus 10, and it will return what? 10. Okay, so in the second, if the when I reaches to 1, then if the user give the input 20 for the first index, second index, I mean the number in the index 1. Okay, so the sum here will be what? The sum is rewritten to 10 in this previous step, so the sum will be 10 plus 20 and it will be 30. Okay, in this way it will continue until the this value of I reaches to the 5. Okay, now let me print here the value. So what will the value? The sum is will be the percentage, of course, and sum is stored in the this sum variable, right? Okay, so let me run this. Okay, let me give an input 10, 20, 30, 40, okay, 50. So the sum is 150. Okay, you can sum these numbers, then you will get what? 150. Okay, so today in this video we discuss about an array, we discuss how we can take the input, how we can print an output of the array, and finally we discuss how we can sum the numbers that are stored in an array. So if you like this video, please do like, share, and subscribe.